guys, we are back and we are back with Kalakatta. Incidentally, I can't show you guys whether it is Kalakatta. This is a sharbat. Sharbat is like a juice in India, and when it's hot we take this. Today we are once again with Dharmesh Mehta ji, who is our superstar, and people are going crazy about him and his knowledge. Dharmesh bhai, welcome to the show, Dharmesh bhai. I don't know if you see the comments that come on YouTube. You should watch, read some of them.
Just now, last comment, last video, Mars, I have seen. It is by mistake I have gone there. Okay. And I thought that people are asking so much question, means that it is very difficult for you to answer. I could only answer few, 5, 6, 8. And then it is going on. So really you are also doing a good job, because I just pick and just run away.
In fact, one person said that what is the use of asking questions when they are not answered? So, you know, it is to the viewers, we are sorry, but it's very difficult for us to reply, especially some of the questions are so deep. You know, I realize one thing at least, I mean, for me to reply to those questions is next to impossible. I do not have that kind of knowledge. Of course, we must request Dharmesh Mehta ji to at times reply to those comments.
I feel that I should fix a day, some period, some time, so that I will see to it and I'll answer. Definitely I'll answer.
So what is our topic today? It is Saturn. I posted some questions on Facebook. I'm going to read out those. I just posted that we're going to do an interview with you on Saturn Untold. So people, I think there are some 20-30 comments on it, people asking questions, you know. So maybe if we get time, we should do that,
But I feel that after, I think my lecture was video posted, maybe half of the many people will get their answer. That's because good. I literally covered the entire area. And Saturn, at least it should not be disclosed. You have disclosed the secret of the Saturn. Now, Saturn is a Saturn planet which has an inbuilt energy.
Okay.
It should not be. So, as per my terms, the Saturn is a, I always say Saturn is a surety.
Surety?
Yeah. Many people in the initial stage say, surety, Shani. No. So many people disagree, but after the completion of lecture, you'll able to know that Shani is only a guarantee and surety. Okay. Shani is sure.
Means whatever Saturn has to give, it will give 100%.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. See, if you see the mythological story that Saturn is a son of the Surya. Surya is very much famous for its particularness, principle, discipline, particularly. Don't you think the son of the discipline will also undergo with the same discipline?
Correct.
See, whenever we take the son, at least we have taken the son first, then father. son will take later. But whenever the Saturn comes, no, people frighten. But when sun comes, see, sun is a very highly inefficient planet. In my sun video, I'll tell you. But sun never gives the result. It's just the people's craze that sun gives the result. No, they never give. The result is always given by the Saturn, Shani. That is a pious obligation in the law, that if any debt was taken by father, any word such given by the father has to be fulfilled in the absence of him by his son. That is a pious obligation.
Yes. We have this like a traditional rule in India, you know.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Your father said this, you have to do it.
So Saturn is a son.
Okay.
See, in our Shastra, the first son, first child of the family is only called a putra. The definition of putra means pu plus atra. Pu means who is going to lead to, and atra means swarga. Who lead to the swarga is a putra. So Shani is only called a surya putra. See, all the planet has come out of the sun only. Mercury, Venus, everything. But why Shani is called? Because sun only trusts on Saturn. That nobody will give, then Saturn will give. I read one book, Shani Shaman, very good book.
Yes, yes. Mridula Trivedi. Yeah, yeah.
Very
fantastic
nice
book. Fantastic.
In so many texts.
K.P. Trivedi, you know, that they got another book, Sunny Dig Darshan. We have that.
Okay.
Trivedi has done research on Saturn. I have never found anybody doing so in-depth research. Right. I always recommend it. It's in Hindi actually. Mm. But Shani Shaman, I think, is in English.
Yeah, that's a nice book. Whereby when I read it 95, I come to know Shani, Sade Sati, Shani will never give me a bad result. Why? Because Shani only grant the surety. It only gives the surety. That is why from Sun to Venus, all planets are called Chalit Grah. Chalit means who tells something and gives something. But Shani is called sure. Shani, whatever he says, he'll give the result. So that is why I say the Shani is a surety. Many people think that the Saturn is a delay, Saturn is, whenever anything happens, people say, are Shani kharab hai, Shani is bad for me. No, Shani only needs something to be performed, then only you will get a result. So that is why the surety. The houses are occupied by Saturn, owned by Saturn. You have a guarantee that before your end of your life, you will get the result of the house. That surety Shani has given. Because why Shani gives the surety? Because he will going to get your debt. No? So prior to that, he will award you the things you have. So that is why Shani is a surety. People think that as it gives a delay. See that, that is again the calculation part comes. Why Shani gives result delay? I think nobody has gone in depth to that. See, whatever the clock, whatever the time we want, I want this thing on Monday, this thing on today. Right? People think that ye mujhe abhi milna chahiye, kal milna chahiye. They are seeing their watch. This watch is governed by the solar things, sun motion. But sun is not going to give a result. This motion is the earth motion against the sun. But result will be given by the Saturn, who is the last.
Kal.
So you are wearing the clock with the sun motion and you are expecting result from the Saturn. How it will give it.
Okay.
So moon, whenever it moves 30 days, your mind moves 360 degrees within 30 days, it took 30 years to Saturn. see the difference. So that is why Shani, that is why I don't only agree on the surety. I said that Shani is delay but sure. That delay is only the anxiety. One thing I assure that Shani principle is that I'll give you your necessity, not your need. That is Shani's quotation.
Can we repeat that?
Yeah.
He will give
the
necessity.
Yeah, not need.
Not your desire.
Not your desire, not your need. Desire. Desire is Mars, as we already
said. Right.
So what he gives, you say that beggars are under the rule of Saturn. Even a beggar also entire day he get 2400 calories. Who gives them? That's the surety Shani gives. Shani is ruled on the beggars, no?
Correct.
All laborers, beggars, they are getting the money to survive their life. It's a necessity. But they are not getting the needs. See, that is why Shani is a surety, that it gives you the sufficient means. Whatever will be your necessity, whatever should be your need, I want house, I want... No, he'll give a basic necessity to live the people. So as a new thing about the Shani, I don't believe it is a new, but it gives a surety. See, this is the second largest planet in your house, in your Kundli. Because it has a two sign, it plays in one house, it has the aspect of 3, 6 and 4 plays, it is Karaka, 6, 8, 12 and 10. So 10 house it rules.
And exaltation, debilitation if you take.
Yeah, that will be included within the house. But Shani gives the, after the Jupiter, Jupiter have one more stage of a 11 house occupied and Saturn has a 10th house. Mars, we already discussed the 9th house. So Saturn gives the surety of your 9th house. And this 9th house, automation it is ruling as per the Saturn. The houses are clashing. See, houses are clashing with the Jupiter and Saturn. What happened? Jupiter will expand the house, but result you will get at the time of Saturn only. So that is the beauty of Saturn. When we talk about the beauty of the Saturn and planets, on that time I will explain you. So now, it is sure that Shani is surety. This all planet, let me give you the small example. Like Sun. Sun gives everything in the bright shade, but people burn out. You stay more time and face the Sun, what happens? You can't face. You can face entire night. Just see sky. You can face entire night, but face the Sun, you will not know. Moon is a mood. Sometimes your mood is positive, sometimes negative. Mars is desire, already we have discussed. Sometimes desire fulfilled, sometimes not. Even though burning desire, if it's not reachable, not going to happen. Mercury is a mind. It may lead to positive, negative. Jupiter only know the growth, whether it is necessary or not. It can expand your sixth house. What will do? You have no things. But Venus give you something in the habitual matter, and then you will be addicted. That's Venus. That's a negative force. That is why from Sun to Venus, it's called Chalit Grah. They give something, they show something, and they give adversely. But Shani, it will not show anything. It's a dark. You only come to know when the results serve on your table, when the deeds comes out. So that is a Saturn.
Basically, Saturn is like that Akshay Kumar dialogue. You know, jo bolta hai, wo karta hai. Jo main bolta hu, wo karta hai. Something like that, right?
Right. So Saturn, that
is what he says, he gives, he delivers.
That gives. So the my viewer, I should say that don't threaten of the Saturn. Why people threaten about Saturn? Because they are not performing their deeds.
Apna paap se dar lagta hai.
They are scared of their deeds. They are scaring about their deeds. Shani, whenever you go to Shani, Shani will ask you, what you have done? Tell me, then I'll give you result. People have not done anything, and just they are standing on the queue that we'll also get something. No, Saturn wants something. There was a condition applied. See, some condition and the star mark is
star
there.
Mark.
And star mark at the below condition.
Okay.
Saturn gives certain thing, that's a hidden condition, and there's no more hidden. He says, first perform, then come to me. I am not like my father that show everything. He says like this. So Saturn says, no, I am not like my father. Don't try to impress me. Do your deeds. Do your karma. And we all have come here because of some of the karma. So Shani. So that was a Shani. Now if you see the houses occupied by every house. If suppose you have the ascendant Capricorn or Aquarius. That means your body is torn with the discipline. You only act. See, I've seen the, you know, Amitabh Bachchan, Kumbh Lagna. So Makar Lagna and Kumbh Lagna, you'll see they are dedicated to their work. Their body only dedicated to work only, they will not see here and there. So that is a dedication of the Saturn. Certain people long last, that is why it says that they long last, they work for years. So that is the power of Saturn being the ascendant. Or even though Saturn has placed any house, that means what happened, that he will synchronize or zip that house. He'll wait for that thing. You did do something, then only I'll give you. Saturn are considered bad in the second house. People think that the second house Saturn is placed, then your all deeds, whatever you do for your families, will not be reciprocal to you immediately. Okay, no? Some of the other day, before your death, see, many times it happens that due to the Saturn placement in second house or the being a lord of the second house, your family people may misinterpret you, and they leave for the space of a time. But at the end, they realize, no, that person was right.
You are right. I just remembered a horoscope. You are, that man has exalted Jupiter in the seventh house.
No.
He's got Jupiter. Okay, no, it's not that horoscope. I'm so sorry. No, but speaking of Saturn in the second house, okay, what I was thinking is, normally what people say, and I think Mahatma Gandhi had Saturn in the second house, I always give that example,
okay,
let me rest before I shoot my mouth off, you know, Mahatma Gandhi has Saturn in the second house. Now, I'll come to Mahatma Gandhi's horoscope later, but I wanted to know your view. Normally it is said, Saturn in second house, the person opens his mouth, he will tell a lie. Okay. Normally it is said like that. I have seen several people, they are like that, absolutely like that. And another chart I remember of my old friend, school friend, Saturn Sun in the second house together. Okay, he opens his mouth, it's a lie. But at the same time, he had a lot of problems with the government also. You know, he deals with the government, etc.
Sun and
Saturn. That.
Yeah.
Mahatma Gandhi. I mean, Saturn in the second house. I know several people who are absolutely crooks of the highest nature.
Yeah.
Mahatma Gandhi has Saturn in the second house. What I read somewhere that, see, which is the karaka of lying, jhoot. Jhoot ka karaka, Saturn.
Saturn.
To tell a lie.
Yeah.
Saturn is the karaka.
Moon and Saturn.
Second house is speech. So this dictum works in those cases. But in Mahatma Gandhi's horoscope, Saturn in the second house in Scorpio. What I remember reading somewhere, he once took a pratigya or like an oath. I will never say a lie.
His book is famous. My experiments on
truth. Yeah, so yeah, actually you go to see, he's written on that.
Okay. Yeah.
So he did that, and that's when his life changed and became so popular. You know? So I just wanted to bring this out because many people, you know, we form a dictum.
Yeah.
We form a dictum. Mm. Rahu in the fourth house, kutta kameena rahega, you know, that kind of thing. A person will be a crook, you know.
Right.
But
right.
It depends on how the other planets shaped.
Yes.
And influenced that Rahu in the fourth house or Saturn in the second house.
Saturn,
you know.
Saturn.
So many people, I was reading one of the comments on your video, and somebody wrote over there, we can't form an opinion with just one planet. You know, it's obvious, it is common sense.
Yeah.
You can't form an opinion with one planet. Okay, you have to see the whole horoscope. But when you are studying astrology, the rishis are also written it in sutra form. This planet in this house, this planet in this house. Then you have to integrate. It can't be repeated every time.
Right.
You know.
The basic source should be always there. There's a basic core part.
Yeah.
Saturn and this house apply everywhere.
Yeah.
Then apply everywhere. So what happened is, why Saturn in the second house lies? Because Saturn doesn't want to leave the relation. That is why he lies. See, he doesn't want to leave the person. That is why he sees that the person will go if I tell the truth. So that is why he lies. And see the simultaneous effect, when Saturn in the second house, you have to sacrifice your family. You have to sacrifice your own pleasure, aspecting third aspect to the fourth house, aspecting your entire life, eighth house, and aspecting your 11th house, house of fulfillment of desire. If you sacrifice certain things, then you can't sacrifice the person, planet, place in the second house. So second house, Saturn, many people say that their money is always used by others, either bank or anything, because he is conjuice.
Oh, Saturn is miser.
Miser. He has everything, but he will not use. He will use small denomination. He can't use the entire thing, because he thinks the necessity should be given priority, not the need. As already I said. So it's not a conjuice or a miser. He'll be always utilize the natural thing and necessary thing, not the needs. Needs are in there. Now Saturn in the third house, that is again not second house I say worse, it's the third house which says worse.
Really?
Why it is worse? Because third house is the house to do something new things. It's a sahas, daring, purushar. So at that time what happened, Saturn in the third house being the house of his enemy, Mars. Third house, Karaka is Mars. Daring. And Saturn will put restriction on it. See why Saturn people are scared about Saturn, because he imposed first duties. And all planet gives first benefits. Then you have to fulfill your duty. Whereas Saturn first, this is a reasonable restriction, then only I'll give you. See, he put his condition first. No? So Saturn will put the condition, no, I will only allow two daring. And people have a lots of daring. How you can impose other source, it will aspect your fifth house, it will slow down your all past deeds, it will never allow the past deeds to come and jump, it will block your luck third house aspecting to the ninth house, and it will also block your 12th house. It will not allow to go beyond some bandhan, some rishu.
But what if it's a Libra Lagna and Saturn is a Yog Karaka? Then what happens?
Saturn is
your Karak and Saturn in the third house. Saturn being a yog karak.
Negative, sir. Negative. Being its place 12th to its house. It's 12th house. It's a lot of 4th house. And it's placing in the 3rd house. Again, negative. For 5th house, you can say that it will give some result of 5th house. Being a yog karak. Because yog karak is the second most powerful planet in your horoscope. I like Saturn in the 4th house. I like. Because Saturn regulate 4th house. Will not incline much in the pleasure. You will be always watching your enemies. You will always be questioned about your deeds, 10th house. And you are always regular with your body. Aspecting the 1st house. So 4th house Saturn, I believe. And 10th house Sun. What happened that 10th house Sun and 4th house Saturn, Saturn will become retrograde at that moment. Being the same opposite to the Sun,
correct.
It will be retrograde. So instead of name and fame, people will be earning so much of wealth. See, when the retrogression comes, no, planet retrogression, then I'll explain you. Shani is very good in the retrogression because altogether Shani is taking rebel and revenge to the Sun. When he got the chance, because when he got chance, just when he is opposite to the Sun, he becomes retrograde. So now he will never listen to his father. So retrograde Saturn, see retrograde Jupiter, okay, I can see that. But retrograde Saturn, very good, because they are all, see normally Sunny is like a bump. You have a bump, no, in the road. So you have to slow down your movement, just overcome it, and then you have to start your motion. It's a bump or the speed breaker. So this is Saturn in the 4th house, I consider very good. People will not more inclined in the material pleasure. They are always questioned about their enemies, their deeds and their physical appearance. So that is very
good. What if I can pass an observation on few charts? I'm using the SRS software, Saptarishi's research software.
Yeah.
So quickly, I put Saturn in the 4th house and I was just trying to see who all have it.
Yeah.
But I found that comment you made about Sun opposite.
Yeah.
Like when Saturn is retrograde, so obviously Sun would be 9, 10.
9, 10, 11.
What I feel is these people with Saturn retrograde in the 4th house, I written an article on it in one of the editorials. They will have one strong pending karma towards their mother or mother figures. And towards their relatives, because third aspect on sixth, relatives or
material.
Even enemies.
Yeah.
You know?
Okay. Ha.
Even enemies. Yeah.
Some balance.
And they will land up doing something for the father or against the father.
Uh-huh.
It is like a vachan diya. They have to fulfill. Vachan is English mein kya bolega? Like father
sentence.
Said something.
Sentence.
Yeah. Father said something, and he has to fulfill that.
Yeah.
You know. Their life, especially Saturn Sun oppositions, or retrograde Saturn and Sun, this kind of things. What I believe, a very strong incident in their life happens around the father's death, or something to do with father, and their life starts or downfall, whatever. This is my observation. We should test it out more.
Yeah, when I come to yoga, now that's a Sun Surya opposition called Chaturbhanga Yoga. Then when we enter, then that will be better time.
Okay,
that
will be better time. Yeah.
So that is a Saturn in the 4th house. Now Saturn in the 5th house. 5th house, again, it's a neutral. It's not so powerful. Because 5th house, when it is there, it will delay your past deeds to cater you. It will be delay for your marriage also. It will be delay to fulfill your ichha purtiment, desire fulfillment, and it will delay your family house also. That is why it is average.
But why Saturn in the 5th house? In certain cases, no childbirth or struggle in getting a child.
Okay.
And in certain cases, very fast. Why?
See what happened that Saturn in the 7th house actually, whenever Saturn in the 7th house, people get married earlier.
Yeah, normally they'll say Saturn 7th house delay. And we see both also, both result. Either too early or too this thing. Or Saturn in the 7th house, people will say old lady or old partner will be.
No, see what happened, that's a misinterpretation of Saturn. As I told you, that Saturn give you in his own time. not your time. What time you are calculating early, late, 20 will be early, 35, 40 will be late. It is for your things. For Saturn, it is no early index. Whenever your deeds pop up, Saturn gives the result. So, for Saturn, now it is the 5th house, then 6th house. Again, it's a Karaka of 6th house. See, in the everywhere where the Saturn is a Karaka, he is playing a defensive role. Wherever the Saturn is placed, no? See, in the 8th house, he is the only Karaka. 12th house is the only Karaka. But in 6th and 10th house, he is being a defensive mechanism. Like in the Mars, I say Roga, Rin, disease, death, then maternal relation, and Shatru, enemies, are the Mars things. In defense of these, Saturn have the service, like Nokri is Saturn, your the servant is Saturn, your court kachiri, the
courts,
it's Saturn. Why you have to go court for Mars, enemies, opposition? Why you have to go to hospitalize? Because hospitalization again comes under Saturn. So, because disease also occur in the 6th house, so hospitalization also in the 6th house by Saturn. So, Saturn always set a mechanism to safeguard the Mars. Whatever Mars has done negative, it will put positive thing. But Saturn in the 6th house, I found that the people are in the job, never been satisfied being the Karak Bhavan Ashaniyam rules. So, what happened? They are doing job, but they are criticizing the job. Because it's not giving them result. Because Saturn, see, normally those who are in the service, they have to perform their duty hours. They are under the duty, but not they are performing the duty. You'll find, I seen the Saturn in the 6th house, they are most of the government servant or the servant of the king, or they are serving to the kings. King, or today's you can say all the minister and everything. So what happened? They are the duty bound, but not performing the duty. That is always they have a dissatisfaction about the job. After the 35 years, 40 years, they retire, they still have a complaint that I not get the things which I should deserve. Sorry. So what happened? Now the Saturn in the 7th house, when it is in 7th house, again it will be the early to say that the marriage will be hidden. See what happened, that if Saturn is settled in the 7th house, how it settled? If it is an own sign, if it is exalted with the friends, he will be settled. That means he will not object you. He will not object you. You perform your reads. But that happens, Saturn gives everything suddenly. So 7th house, then in the 8th house, as I said, that in the 7th house when it is there, you search the person from where you are not going to search. So see, why it give you a delay? Because you are not searching in the right direction. So now in the 8th house, when the Saturn in the 8th house, I like in the 8th house because it will regulate. Originally, Karaka Bhavanashe, it applies to Karaka Bhavanashe. So what happened? It will delay your ending. So it is good. It's for a long lifespan. People always misinterpret 8th house. 8th house is not a house of death, let me tell you.
Okay.
It's a house of life. You are alive.
Longevity.
You are alive, so you have to see from 8th house how much I am going to live. The other side of it is when I will die. But you are not focusing the death, you are focusing life.
Be positive. Focus on the life.
Yeah. So what happened, that Saturn in the 8th house means you will stretch your life. Till your deeds end. Till the last deed happens. So that is why you will many times find that people say, he has settled everything, then he left. That is the Saturn in the 8th house, because he will never let you left the place until you complete your deeds. So that's a very good indication, the Saturn in the... And again, it will aspecting your 10th house, good. It is aspecting your 2nd house, good. And it is aspecting your 5th house, it's good. Because where it has to be really to be controlled, your family, your deeds, it has not to be just flourished. See, what the Saturn is there in the body, why he has given the Karaka of a life? Because every day your some of the other cells are dying, your cell. See, cell have that's outer part. Shell, every cell have an outer part, it's called a ketone in the scientific level. So what happened, that when the cell is used, every cell, then it will blast, and this the balance, what you say, balance,
Balance, yeah.
Whatever the balance, no, this all are second. So they accumulate and they will pure it and it goes out of the body. Okay. So every day your new cells are making and your old cells are letting. They are going. So to control this new and all, this is a second. Because Saturn will not accelerate the speed and it will not decrease the speed of dating. That is why Saturn has kept, because our age is from the aging. You know the aging. Aging means that when you die, so how much age you have, your body mass index, your age.
Right.
So Saturn basically governs with the cell. I like the cell. See all the veins, all the hairs, black, this all are governed under the Saturn. So Saturn always try to control the things. So 8th house Saturn is good.
9th house Saturn, you were saying?
Yeah, it will land you to some other place. Saturn always, because at the Saturn also is a dark place. So where you have never thought about that you are going to go this place, it will land you because it's a long traveling. And Saturn also like a long traveling. So Saturn in the 9th house, because it will control your dates, 11th house, it is aspecting your 3rd house and it's aspecting your 6th house. It's a good place to sit Saturn. Then in 10th house, whenever the Saturn is in 10th house, again it is in the protective mode and it will not let your name and fame, your deeds will be recognized, not your name will be recognized. If the sun will be there, your name will be recognized, not your deeds. But the Saturn in the 10th house, your deeds will be recognized. This person has done this thing.
Okay.
So Saturn in the 10th house, always your deeds will be spoken.
They're on Saturn in the 11th house. Anything special about Saturn in the 11th house?
The Saturn in 11th house means you will get a time between one desire fulfillment and the other desire you are going to fulfill. So that space, at least you can enjoy that distance between the one desire. What happens that after the one desire expires, no, means fulfilled, no, people will start thinking about the next desire. But the Saturn in the 11th house, what, one at a time. Once you complete the desire, you will celebrate, you will enjoy, and then only you will shift to the other desire. So you will get some space between the enjoyment of a two simultaneous desire. So that's the benefit you get in the Saturn in 11th house. Saturn in 12th house, what happened? The 12th house being is a Karak, only Karaka, significator of the 12th house. When Saturn in the 12th house, it is the worst because you will not follow any rules and regulations. You will violate your own principle.
That's a good point.
Yeah, because Karak Bhavana says Saturn basically for the bindingness of the any rules. Shani will bind your rules. But if it is in the binding house, so it is a Karak Bhavana says, you will never bind the rules. You will always try to break all the rules. You will never come under the any ones. So that is the worst part of the Saturn, because it will aspect your 2nd house, it will aspect your 6th house, and it will aspect your 9th house. So everywhere it is a negative effect. You will not follow the rules of the society, rules of everywhere there is a rule. You will always try to, that is why 12th house Saturn, it is always said there is a chance of imprisonment. Why it is imprisonment? Because you have violated some rules.
Okay.
You have broken some rules and regulations. That is why Saturn in the 12th house says the people are going to face some or the other imprisonment. See, that imprisonment is not a real solitary confinement or the confinement under the bar. It will be a social boycott. People will not interact with you. People will boycott you socially. So it will be 12th house because you are now and then you are habitual to break all the rules. So being a Saturn in Saturn, as I told you, that Saturn in the 3rd house, 6th house and 9th house, being the Kendra from 12th house, it's very good. Because anything goes to the Kendra, that is in my Kendra article, I say that Kendra means regular. So if Saturn, any was Saturn is 3rd house, 6th house or 9th house, he'll be following all the rules and regulation continuously. But when Saturn plays in his own binding house, 12th house, it will break maximum house and that will also suffer him at the ending also when his time comes, because 12th house is after that when body remains here and your soul goes up for the balancing the things, that time also it will curse because he says that you have not fulfilled the all rules, so now you have to wait. So your soul will, as we write RIP, rest in soul, peace. But if Saturn in the 12th house, will never rest after the in the peace. So 12 hours is very worse for the Saturn to see.
I mean, what I let me just open one horoscope.
Yeah.
I want to just double check that. Because it's been 10 years since I opened that horoscope. See, our guru, both of us have a common guru, which is C.S. Patel sir.
Yes, sir.
Patel sir had Saturn retrograde in the 12th house. And what I've seen, Saturn in the 12th house, okay, the ending time is not smooth.
Yeah.
Patel sahab also was on ventilator.
Suffering.
For 1 week he was on ventilator, more than that. Okay.
Yeah.
And that's suffering. And then finally that throat thing, we had to remove it.
Yeah.
And then as soon as we removed the ventilator, he choked and he died. You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So the ending part is this thing. What, okay, I wanted to say a few things, you know, my observations. And taking this session with you, because you can form, give us a feedback right now, or maybe you can observe, because you see so many hundreds of horoscopes, thousands of horoscopes you see. Saturn associated with earth houses.
Yeah.
2, 11 kind of houses, or maybe 7 or 10, whatever, you know.
Mm.
Because this is a half-baked observation of mine, I need to. Tested aggressively. Saturn in the 2nd house or Saturn in the 11th house. Person will have, can have, chances of having 1.5 jobs. Like one regular job and the other like a freelance kind of job, you know.
See, he tried to make himself involved in many activities.
Yeah.
That's the main thing, that he should always involve behind the money and the deeds. See, money is a secondary for him. It is always the deed to be always a priority. So that is why for family also he'll be dedicated, for finance also he'll be dedicated. And as that I said, that in 11th house Saturn gives a good result, because at least you enjoy the fulfillment of your joy and this. Now we'll see about the...
Another thing that I want to say, sorry to... If Saturn is spoiled, then the 10th house from it, or you can say 10th aspect, has possibility to create scandal. Or where the 10th lord goes and sits.
Okay.
Okay. For example, 3 horoscopes. Saturn in the 11th house, John F. Kennedy, president.
Okay.
Okay. So the 10th aspect goes to 8th house. Okay. And let me just open up. There in the 8th house, Mars Mercury is there. Okay.
Right.
Okay. So this is the 10th aspect. 8th house is sex scandals.
Right.
He had Marilyn Monroe.
Right.
Then you have another person called Christine Keeler.
Okay.
Saturn in the 11th house with Mars. 10th from it will be the 8th house. It has Mercury and Venus. Again Mercury coming. Okay. Then Bill Clinton. If I'm talking from memory, one second, I open this. Bill Clinton, Monica Lewinsky case.
Right.
Saturn is with Mercury in the 11th house. Again, 10th aspect goes to 8th house where Moon is there. Okay.
Right.
Moon has 27 wives, whatever we know all that. But I'll give another example. Saturn in the 8th house, the 10th aspect is in the 5th house. 5th house is love affairs. Okay. The person had few love affairs. Okay, very few, just 2-3, which is normal in today's term.
Right.
But all of them created
scandals.
You know, or where the 5th lord will go and sit, you know.
Okay.
In another case, Saturn in the 8th house, the 5th house will be the 10th aspect. The 5th lord is going and sitting in the 4th house of mother.
Okay.
The mother had a scandal. So this is depending on if the Saturn is afflicted.
Saturn is afflicted.
Afflicted. People can observe this, give their feedback. Okay.
Yeah.
Long, many years back I had, you know, tested this. So this 1.5, you know, because Saturn 2 leg.
Yeah.
But one leg is
broken.
Half. So from there it is one and a half. I normally don't give logic because
people then start using, misusing rather. But let us test this and people can get back.
Now we'll see conjunction and sitting with the Saturn, how it happens. When it say sit with the Sun, it is said that the Surya Shani when sit together, it is called Chatrabhanga. Either it is opposite to each other or with the sitting with the each other. Because as Sun was scared, Surya was scared that if my child becomes so powerful, then nobody will pray me. That is why on the going on the way, he has just dropped his Sun. He has just he has just removed his Sun and he has passed the that time horse cart to his leg. That is why his leg was broken.
I mean, the other thing was the mother Sanjana, that was the other story, the Sanjana.
Yeah.
You know, she cursed and the leg started.
It says that during that time the king should not be defamed. So that is why he said if his leg was broken, then he will never become a king. So that was a mythology. There are so many rishis have their own ideas.
Many Purans are
there. Yeah, that is why it is called Sanish Charayanava. Means he is running by this unbalanced leg.
You know, shall I tell you something? Today morning I got up. Okay, sorry to deviate, guys. Today morning I got up and we have a very powerful Shani Mandir right next to our house. Shreyas ke andar ka lane mein. Shetty Lok ka hai. It is very powerful. And at a point of time, I used to go there daily for 1 year. I used to go there daily and sit over there. I think way back in 2006. Yeah. Anyway, today morning I got up and I thought I have to go there. And somehow in the hurry, I came here. And while I was on the, I sat in the car. Your phone call came. Let's do Saturn today.
By way of me, the Saturn has reminded you that you have to come to me. Anyway, I am coming to you. Saturn, when it is seated together, that means a Chatrabhanga, due to which what happened, till the father subsides, the sun will never rise. So that is why whenever the Surya Sun is together or opposite to each other, we advise the father, please let your son to go out, otherwise he will never rise.
Remember I told you about that friend of mine, he's got Saturn Sun in the second house. Same thing, when till father and son were in the same office, his business was 1 crore down. Then one Jain Muni told him, father you sit at Masjid office and this boy you sit at Ghatkopar office.
Right.
And then this man came so high.
Because see, why they say that? Because day and night never appeared together. That's the reason, that's the logic. When it is day, you can't say it's a night, and in night, you can't say it's a
night. Saturn is strong in the night.
Yeah,
Saturn is Vayu Tattva.
Vayu Tattva, it's a night, darkness. See, Saturn has a two sign, deviating Makara and Kumbha. The Makara is a dilated form of Saturn, and Kumbha is a pure form of Saturn. The Kumbha, the Aquarius sign of the Saturn is a black, and the Makara. See, Makara Rasi people state that is a Prithvi Tattva, it is not Prithvi Tattva, it's a ether sign, it's a Akash Tattva. We have 5 elements in the Hindu mythology: Agni, Prithvi, Vayu, Jal, and Akash. Where Akash? Akash is there in Makar Rasi.
Okay.
So, Makar Rasi, whenever it rises, it gives a blue effect. See, whenever you see sky as a blue, no? So, that is Shani, Makar Rasi. And after the sun goes deeper, it becomes dark black, then Kumbh Rasi appears. So Makar and Kumbh, the light blue color is as Makar and dark blue is a Kumbh Rasi. Now coming to the Chandra Shani, as the Surya Shani is a Chatrabhanga, Chandra Shani is called Vishyo.
Poison.
See, that poison doesn't mean I drink something and it will be poisonous. Why it is called poisonous? Because moon is a mood and Saturn is a delay. So due to the delay every time, the mood might have thought so many things, but Saturn doesn't allow to give. So what happened? That poison goes inside the body. I am not getting things. So their way of seeing others will become wish.
Okay.
That is why it is called Vishya Yoga. Talking to the Saturn and Mars, it is called Sangharsha Yoga. Saturn Mars. The great Navin Javeri.
Written
the book on the Sani Mangal Yati Pratyati. One should get such type of book.
No, I tried to getting it translated also.
Okay.
One of my friends, UC Mehta.
UC Mehta
sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. He promised me, I think so, 5 years back.
Nothing. It's such a beautiful book, Saturn-Mars combination, for all different lagnas, different houses.
Some of the crux I have given in my Mars. In Mars lecture, I have given Saturn-Mars chasing. So whenever Saturn-Mars is together, you will find the person having from his own food. Will grow from his grassroots to the top level by his own efforts. Nobody will support him. So that is why it is called Sangharsa Yoga. People have a fighting nature and they will come up with a slowly they will gradually come up. Saturn Venus, Saturn Mercury is not a good combination. It is sometimes called a Nipun Yoga, but I don't feel that is a Nipun Yoga. When in the Mercury Saturn also I have said same thing, but whenever the Saturn and Mercury is there, see, they are very good scheme maker, but negative shape. See, application of mind, both as I said, application of mind. And when it's set with the Saturn, so people always have a dark shade more than the bright shade. Because your mind is always influenced by the dark things. See, like a hackers. See, they are also using computer, they are also using the system, everything they are using. But they are using in adverse mode. Application of mind in the adverse things. In the night thing, in the dark thing. Saturn and Jupiter, it is called Adhyatmik Yoga. See, there are two Adhyatmik Yoga Rishi has mentioned. One Surya Guru Adhyatmik Yoga and one Shani Guru Adhyatmik Yoga. The difference between Surya Guru Adhyatmik Yoga and Shani Guru Adhyatmik Yoga is Surya Guru Adhyatmik Yoga, you will see the person showing the lights, but not application actually. See, he tell everything. There are so many Babas, you know, aware about this. They say, don't do this, don't do that. It is avoid, and they themselves are doing. Because in the face, they are something different.
That's
than
Sun
in the
Jupiter.
Sun Jupiter. Because that is also Adhyatmik Yoga. Sun will highlight the Jupiter. So, you will find that he is very
spiritual.
But he is not in action. Indeed, he is not spiritual. He is not applying the same principle to himself. But certainly apply to himself, no? So Shani Guru Adhyatmik Yoga means he deeply have the spirituality, not a religiousness will come out, but spirituality, devotion, yoga, meditation, that will come out. So that is Saturn and Jupiter.
So does it like also Saturn Jupiter opposition?
Yes, Saturn same.
Or Jupiter aspecting on Saturn or Saturn aspecting on Jupiter?
Gravity will reduce. Gravity only reduce. We'll find Barack Obama, Makar Lagna, Shani Guru. So every 20 years, 61, 81, 2001, now 2021, both will join together. Saturn, Jupiter, always 20 years they come back. So Saturn, Jupiter, that's a spiritual man, deeply rooted man, and they have application growth with their own stability. Saturn with the Venus, it's a good combination because one is pleasure and one is a sorrow. So there will be always a compatibility between two. See, you will always find the Venus always go hand in hand with the Saturn. In the Saturn ascendant, Venus is a Yogkaraka, and in Yoga, Venus ascendant, Shani is a Yogkaraka. Why it is so? Because it is a definition of pleasure and sorrow, Dukkh or Sukh. When you enjoy the Sukh, when Dukkh will over. When you enjoy the Dukkh, when Sukh will over.
You know, but I always find people with Saturn-Venus combination. They always get some dukkh, some sorrow with women folk.
Okay, Venus being a planet of the Venus.
I'll tell a story which my friend Arnab Mukherjee said to me. He met an astrologer in Ujjain, right near Mahakal temple.
Okay.
And that man said 3-4 rare things about Saturn-Venus combination. I'm just remembering one. Something he said. He said, such people will be surrounded by women. And another thing is, spoke about spirituality, I'm forgetting that. But if one wants to read further, they should read Chandrakala Nadi by R. Santanam translation. In that, I always repeat this combination, Saturn-Venus. Chandrakala Nadi says, such a person with Saturn-Venus combination will run around yogis. Finally, he will come to one place and go deeper within himself.
Yeah.
The initial phase will be running around yogis. You know, so many people, you know,
yeah.
There are two kinds of people I find in our Jyotish thing.
Mm-hmm.
One who will go and meet every astrologer in India. They just want to meet every astrologer in India. Yeah. For what, I do not know. Maybe to learn, or maybe to show off that I met so many people. Mm. Or maybe to gather secrets. Mm. Everyone has their own choices. Mm. Same goes with many people in spirituality. They will go and meet hundreds of yogis.
All yogis and Malas.
Probably they have this kind of combination, I do not
know. Yeah, as I say, they find first, in the initial state, they find the pleasure. Then they realize that pleasure is not outside, it is within. Yeah. So they come back. Now Saturn Rahu, it's called as Rapid Dosh. In the Saturn Rahu or Saturn
Ketu. Cursed.
Rapid. That your horoscope is somewhat, because of your last birth, your dirt did something wrong, so you have to perform this birth. So that is why Saturn Rahu is called as Rapid Dosh. You'll get something on. Now layman could not be judging what wrong they are, and so they just do the Shanti, Puja, Home, Havan for the Rapid Dosh. But for one person has to see for Saturn, if Saturn is powerful or not, I'll give you one secret. You purchase a lottery ticket first.
Okay.
That's the secret of Saturn.
Okay.
You purchase a lottery ticket.
Okay.
And for 10 rupees, if you get a 10 rupees, then your Saturn is powerful. Your Saturn is okay with you. He's not giving you hard things. See why I'm telling you, that the reason I will give you later on. If you purchase a lottery and you lose 10 rupees, it is good that to whom you have to pay, you have already paid. That is also good. But that means you have to work only, there is no gain in your child. But for 10 rupees, if you earn 100 rupees, if you have lottery, that means your Saturn is very much powerful. See, Saturn work both the side.
It's giving you from your previous life, it's giving you now.
Yeah.
What he did not give you,
yeah,
or he did not get the opportunity to give you, it's
See,
giving
that
now.
That is why sometimes what happened, the people have just gone for shopping, they have taken the, some coupon, and after a day they realize, oh, they become multi-millionaire. That's Saturn. Because all these other people who have purchased, those who are loose, they have to pay him. No?
Right. Very true.
So they are not going to meet other way, so they have purchased a lottery ticket. So Saturn, for best example for Saturn, whether your Saturn is powerful or not, just purchase a lottery ticket and tell me. If Saturn will give it 10 rupees, 100 rupees, whatever you purchase, not a share or a thing, it's a purely lottery only. Because lottery rules under the Saturn. So that is a Saturn Rahu, Saturn Ketu, that is a Rapid Dosh and everything that a person has to specify. Now we have seen all the conjunction of the house, we have seen all the house Saturn position. Now we'll move about the new thing about the Saturn, is the retrogression and motion. It's no common. But one more new thing for the Saturn is, only Saturn can be stable for 3 days. Saturn, Jupiter one and a half days. See, while they are in motion, no, they have to stop their speed and then they go back. Or otherwise they are in the reverse mode, they will stop there and then there onward they will go motion. So by between the dead distance, the Shani gives very good result during summer.
Yeah.
While in the Margi, while in the motion, he has to apply Sun rule. While in the retrogression, he has to apply his own rule. Okay. By people are happy because Shani will not move, no? So Shani in the move. People things will, people deeds. See, understand the concept. People deeds for 3 days will not be recorded in any minutes.
Oh.
So that is why yogis and secret, the persons, always wait till the Saturn goes. If you work anything for these 3 days, no, that will not be recorded.
Oh.
That minutes of the days will not be recorded in any way. So that's a secret.
Oh, that's a big, big secret you have given us, sir.
Just apply it. Just apply it. Yes. See what happened in the retrogression. See, if we speak, whatever till now I speak of the motion of the Saturn.
Right.
Now you see the retrogression of Saturn. When Saturn is retrograde. See, I advise the viewers, don't ask the each housewife. Saturn in 10th house, retrogression 4th house, 5th house, because anyway Saturn is retrograde. You have to understand the concept that Saturn is retrograde. When it is retrograde, it means now he got a chance to give result by his own choice. Now he become more powerful. See what happened, Shani has to give result of your deeds. What deeds? The deeds which has shown by sun. He has done this, this, this. The deeds which is not shown by the sun at present. Sun means your soul. The soul has not pop up the deeds, will never be rewarded by sunny. But if it is retrograded in any one horoscope, that means he runs smoothly. His work will not be obstructed in any way. So that is why sunny Saturn retrogression, when he got a chance to give result, will give ample of result. Because that's the time when he got a chance to rebuild the sun, reverse the sun result, reverse the established principle. Whenever Saturn is retrograding anybody now, he'll break the rules. And for the betterment, you see the internal aggression, people have internal aggression, sare niyam tod do, niyam pe chalna chhod do, that's kind of thing. And then the new rules will be framed for them. So, it may lead to that freedom fighting. That's the time you'll see every 30 years that there's a reformation. There's a freedom fighters, if you see the freedom fighter, that might be a Saturn will be retrograde for them. Because they fight for the established British Empire and they got relief out of it. So that Saturn retrogression, if it is in motion, will give slow result. If it is retrograde, you will not believe that Saturn gives such a fast result, because now he has to prove better than his father. That is why on that anger, he'll give you all your deeds result in the one bar. So anyone having a Saturn in retrogression in their planet, they feel they'll able to complete 100 days. If it was in the motion, he will be only able to complete 50 days in this life. So it will double your deeds. So people will be more powerful. That is why C.S. Patel sahab always says that Saturn retrograde, you link with the 9th house Saturn. He always link with something. See, retrogression he wrote, okay, make a kundli. So we make the kundli. Now I'll teach you the retrogression. Okay. So he wrote, okay, write 4th house Mars and Mercury. We have written Mars and Mercury in 4th house. He said, now write Jupiter in 5th house. Okay, 5th house. Venus in 7th house. See how I remember 25 years all things. Venus in 7th house. He put blindly 7th house. And Saturn in 9th house. Now he say, look into the kundli. What to see now? You don't understand. Now he has given the reason. Whenever Mars is retrograded, he will get ample of a property. That is why he kept in 4th house. When Jupiter is Mercury is retrograde, ample of knowledge. He will study like anything. When Jupiter is retrograded, it's a 5th house. You have so many deeds, good deeds, punya. When Venus is retrograded in 7th house, I should not be, it should be censorized. So people are like a womanizer, they got so many references. Nowadays it's common. And if Saturn is retrograded, it will accelerate your luck. That is why pattern the 9th house. So this is a simple formula for retrogression. Yes, dear.
Saturn 9th house, Venus 7th house, Jupiter 5th house,
Mars 4th house, Mercury in the 4th house. It's a simple formula. Which house Karaka it is, it will accelerate. That's the good symbol, simple example it gives. And at that time, one of my friend was also there. And he say, sir, my Mars is in 4th house. So immediately C.S. Patel said, do you know where your property is there? He said, no, my father also saying that I have so many properties there. But it's difficult to accumulate. He has some property in native, some property here, some property, 3-4, Benami. Benami property. So it was immediately we always give the response to him as a great person. So that was the things of the motion, retrogression and but I give the secret during the period of Saturn, use your deeds. It will give you such a beautiful result. I learned so many secrets during this period. If you concentrate period, no. Many deeds which is not going to pop up, it will come out. And there is no record in your deeds. So that's a good thing.
But so even people can misuse this also, right?
I have given the weapon now to use as
cut an apple or kill someone. Depends on what you use.
So that's the same thing. Now about the Dasha.
Yeah.
Saturn gives good result in Dasha, not Gochar. It is a concept of the human being that Saturn never gives the result in Dasha. Yeah, that's true because it's Dasha. Dasha gives the good result apart because The sun is fixed for the period of 19 years. So the entire 19 years, it will give you the result of the deeds. If you do the deed, then only it will give you. The sun will never allow you to give result without your own performance, own appearance. You have to present at the time of the Saturn. So Saturn gives in the during its dasha. If it is a you can say it's own sign, Kendra, Trikona, good planet. If it is considered to be a good planet in your house, during the Saturn dasha, he will be repaid. All the deeds will give you the ample of result because now his turn has come. What is a dasha? The definition of dasha says in my that Guru Purnima lecture also I said dasha is a graho ka fal dene ka samay and gocha is graho se fal lene ka samay. That's a different thing. People so use dasha and gocha together.
I'm saying it out again. Yeah. Dasha means when the planet will give result. You take the result from the planet.
No, it's reverse.
Sorry.
Dasha means it's a planet say.
Planet have a say.
And whenever the gochar, human being have a say.
Okay.
See, gochar means what? Everything is catering. Like you are when you are going to any marriage, there will be a what system? Buffet system. Right. Now you have to go to the counter and take whatever things you have to take. That is gochar. Because gochar means moving.
Oh, right.
And dasha means when you are sitting in the plane, you have to wait which things are going to come.
That's the best example you're given to
this. So that's the dasha.
You know, people love the examples you give. People just love it. See, continue, sir.
When it is say astrologer, he must have a good logic.
Yeah.
Astrologic. Logic should be strong. Then only you'll see the planet. So I always associate the example in the common people. So in during dasha what happens? Now planet have a say to give you result, no? So it will give you. Now sit back in an armchair and wait. Whatever the deeds you have done, no? Now it will give you result. Why Saturn dasha is worse for the people? Not done anything. That is why he is not able to give you, no? See, if you have already taken, in month you will get a, suppose 2 kilo sugar, 1 kilo rice from rationing. So you will go and once you make an entry, then after 10 days again you go, nahi milega. All the things are lying, now give me enough from this. No, your quota is decided. Every people quota is decided, the Shani only give the result. That is why sometimes I say Shani is a rationing officer. He is a rationing. You will see that whatever things you have done, actually you have 4 people now, you will get 2 kilos. You have 8 people, 10 kilos. So it weight your deeds.
Good deeds, bad deeds.
Good deeds, bad deeds, and accordingly it will give you a result. So that is why dasha of Saturn, just relax, don't be scared. You have to scare at the time of making a deeds. Now it's a result time. So result time you can't do anything. See, people are doing so many things for Saturn that Shani Monday, this, oil. I always restrict, don't spoil the oil. People are pouring the oil. See, I'm not against with anything. But do something with the logical. If you pour in some oil to the Shani, that Devata and something, it will go outside and outside the collector is there. They'll again go and come back. Where the Shani has pleased. Shani is not pleased by it. Okay, give some fry item or oily item to the poor. It is fitted. It is used. Then Shani will please. Shani always see your deeds. What deeds you are doing. People are just wasting liters of oil.
You know, I used to normally tell people, now that you are speaking on remedies, normally tell people, Shani is karma karaka.
Yes.
It's easy to please him, not with mantras, by your deeds. Karma.
Right?
Because Shani is karma karaka.
Right.
You know that way. But speaking of remedies, you know, there is a book Robert Sobota has translated. Yeah, do you mind remembering the first book, Greatness of Saturn? Yeah, that Below that book is my Secret of Astrology, which I passed on to my dear friend Kapil Raj. This book, guys, this is available only in Gujarati language.
Oh, okay.
Shani Mahatme. Robert Sobota translated this book.
Okay.
And in this book, Shani Maharaj has given two remedies.
Okay.
One is that Shani Dashrath Stotra. Okay. He himself says you recite that. And
he says, read the story. Lord Shani himself is telling, read my story.
Okay.
And I have given this book to so many people. And I have told them, just keep up. This is the story of King Vikramaditya.
Okay.
How he lost his legs and hands and everything. From a king, he was reduced to a pauper and everything. Mm. And finally, Shani Maharaj comes and blesses
him.
The story in itself is a therapy. That's the reason it's written a therapeutic myth. It's a therapy. The more you keep on reading this book, and I've done this myself. I used to, in the night time, I used to read this continuously. Okay. You become a bit, I'm a very rude person, very egotistical person, you know. And I realized when I was reading this, I started developing compassion for people.
Oh.
You know, love for people and all that. You know?
Okay, okay.
Yeah, but you got to do this daily. You got to read this daily.
Like a stutra, you have to recite
it. If I remember well, no, not in this, it is not Dattatreya's, this thing, Guru Charitra. That is, you got to sleep on the floor and read it. You can't sleep on the bed for those number of days. Okay. But I'm saying this book is available in English, okay? Mm. You need not buy this book from me, okay? But it's a fantastic book. Sir, from our side, this is a gift to you.
Thank you. So Sunny has pleased me by pleasing.
No, and you know, another thing I wanted to say was this book, Saturn in Transit. Sorry, now I'm promoting my business. Okay, now I'm promoting my business because this book by Erin Sullivan, it's out of print. It has now come back.
Okay.
Yeah, we have this in our bookshop. I need to upload it. It's been 20 days. I'm not even more than a month. It's come. I'm not put it.
No.
But the beauty is, she has used some Western astrology concepts. Erin Sullivan is a beautiful astrologer. I mean, very senior astrologer from the West. And what, you remember I was telling you before we started this recording, that in the West, they have the Saturn return.
Yeah.
Saturn coming on natal Saturn.
Yeah.
Transit Saturn coming on natal Saturn.
Mm.
Happens around 30 years, 29 years, you know,
yeah,
that kind of thing. That is when, that's like the first round of Saturn, that is when there will be major transformation in your life,
right,
for good or for bad.
Right, you know? Right.
Similarly, is Saturn in the second round, which happens in 60s, Shashti, that
right,
we call.
Yes, that's
okay.
Mm.
The point in this book, beautiful, is,
mm,
which I had once discussed with Patel sir, was Saturn, transit Saturn,
mm-hmm,
coming in Kendra to natal Saturn.
Uh-huh.
So the results are here in this book. Yeah, because that in our Vedic astrology, we don't use that much.
Yeah.
But you know, we need to, what I personally believe, you know, whatever my shortcomings are there, I tell others to overcome it, you know.
Yeah.
So we need to have more open mind and do further research. Right. One quick thing I wanted you to touch, which we haven't touched in earlier this thing.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe we can create another series of videos on it, which is nakshatras of each planet.
Oh, okay.
This is Shani's nakshatras, you know,
right,
which I mentioned at the start.
Yeah.
Maybe we should take it up in separate nakshatra series.
Yeah.
What do you say, guys? Do you all want a nakshatra series with Dharmesh Mehta ji? If yes, encourage us, write it, hit the subscribe button and write your comments whether you want nakshatra series. So what we can do is, you know, we can have Shani's nakshatras, like
Anuradha, Anuyada,
Pushya,
and
we can have, for each planet, we will have, after we finish our planet series, we are not going to let you go so fast. You would remain with us for the rest of your life.
I am a man of Saturn, bus.
That's
so security.
What is the last advice that you would like to give?
One more
people?
Thing is left is the gochar. As you said that the returns, the same thing I was also going to say about the transit.
Okay.
Whenever the second transit comes, no. See, for the people who doesn't, those who born in the Mercury Dasa, Ketu Dasa or Sun Dasa, will never face second Dasa in their life. Entire life. People, for coming that Dasa, people have to go at the age of 70, 80. And even though they go to 70, 80, what Sunny will do then? So, but in transit, I always advise my student to always use transit in Kendra only. Don't use transit in triangle house. See, Kendra lecture, I bifurcated square type house and triangle. Eight house has a triangle shape and four has a square in the rectangular shape. So, in set, all the Gochar result you will only find in that Kendra only. Don't apply Gochar in Trikona. It will never give. Trikona have a hidden condition. See, let me show you. Trikona have a hidden condition that Trikona only open during certain time, and that time is Dasha.
Okay.
See, fifth house. It's a triangle house.
Yes.
See, starting from the second house. Second house is your family and money.
Right.
If you lose these two, only time will repay you. You can't repay. You can't get this. That opportunity, third house. If third house, it's a triangle house. If you let some opportunity, you will not dare something, it will never give you another chance. Fifth house, it's again the house of time. Whatever you are, the last birth time, last deeds will come out. Sixth house, every time you will not have enemy. It's a particular time of
life. I seem to have enemies all the time. I don't know why.
Your triangle dasha will be more powerful than
yes.
Because triangle house, see, I'm not saying the fifth and ninth house. Triangle shaped house.
Shape, yeah. So for those who use South Indian charts, they will not understand this concept.
Yeah.
Sir uses North Indian charts.
Diamond chart.
Diamond chart that we call. Yeah. So 1, 4, 7, 10 houses are square in shape.
Yeah, yeah.
Like inverted square.
Yeah.
The rest all are small triangles.
Triangle.
So he's talking about that.
Mm. So all the triangle shaped house are run by the dasha.
Okay.
And all the square shaped house are gochar. That is why you said that 4, 7 and 10
okay. Yeah.
No, there is a secret of this.
Okay.
Because it can, your triangle house only operate during gochar. In dasha it never apply. See why that's a basic condition is that Kendra is called the continuous. So whenever people wish they can take the result of the Kendra, but not at the time of the Trikona. For Trikona you have to wait for the period. Time. There's na janma ka bandhan ho na umr ki seema ho. That is Kendra.
Okay.
Uske liye koi, for Kendra no age is binding. At the what age you can marry?
Any age.
At what age you will learn?
Any age.
4,000.
4,000. Any age.
Any age you can start new work. 10,000. And at any age you can develop the health.
Or spoil your health also.
Spoil. Both the ways. So Kendra rules with the transit.
That's a beautiful example again. Beautiful example.
See, people are miss letting that my guru in the triangle is 6th house, what it will not give result. Let dasha to come. People are just misguiding that Kendras are only operated by gochar and triangle houses are operated by the dasha.
Right.
So what happened that whenever the Shani transiting from your Kendra, as I told you, the 4th house Shani is very powerful, 7th house very powerful, 10th house very powerful. So this is during the gochar, what happened that Shani will again start. Again start. See, it's a period of all 7 half, 7 half, 7 half and 7 half. That is called Sade Sati. So every 7.5 year later, actually it's a 5 years gap. First house is complete, then after 5 years your second will enter in your fourth house. So every 5 years again it will give you a new pleasure. Again 5 years it will give you a new pleasure. Again 5 years it will give you a new pleasure. So when it completes, see, I see gochar as a cycle, not as a planet. See that in my, we are going to start that gochar, no?
Yeah, yeah,
in my gochar, yeah. I'll give you that technique. Don't see planet as a transit. See the cycle which is operating. Just a simple example, that is the age of 36. See, everybody in their life will face something in the age of 36. 36 is a four crossroad. Jupiter will complete its third cycle, Ra will complete its second cycle, and 36 is a good year for the Saturn. Bhagya Varsh is the Saturn. So 36 is Saturn, Jupiter and Rahu. All three planets cross each other. All planets cross each other. That will discuss in the cycle in the transit. But do, dear friend, do apply Saturn transit in Kendra only. Don't spoil your 5 years in Trikon house. It will not affect much. See, it will affect only your phone. He is the regulator of your pleasure. He will always remind you, do something. Why only the Shani has a Sade Sati? Why? Because whenever your moods and it's not controlled, then Saturn will come in come and force you. It will first enter from 11th house when your moon desire will fulfill, will make a restriction. Now think other way. During the Sadasati is the first thing encountered by the people is, now people are leaving me. Why they are leaving? Because Sunny told you that they all are using, misusing you. That is why I am removing him and making you isolated. Be focused your things. When Sunny is transiting on over the moon, it is called the second phase of the Sadasati. First phase is always mental, second is the physical, and third is the financial. So what happened in the second phase, when the Saturn is passing from the moon, it will restrict all your mind thoughts and it will make you see why people become alone, isolated. Why? Because Saturn think that think about yourself, don't think about all this. They all are misusing your deeds. So don't do for them, do for yourself. That is why Jupiter is for the spirituality, for the religious things, and Saturn for spirituality. Spirituality and religion has a two things, two different. Religion, religiousness means togetherness, and spirituality means isolation, oneness. That is a Jupiter and Saturn combination. So that dasha during the gochar, Saturn will give result of the kendra only. Don't be threatened. During that Saturn transit in your triangle shaped house, it will be looked after by the this. But if the Saturn dasha comes, just relax. It will only give you the result of your deeds. So in conclusion, Saturn has so many aspects, but as you told about the nakshatra, see, it has a three nakshatra, Pushya, Anuradha and Vesta. See the timing of the this come. Pushya comes as a Hindu mass Posh, where the Sankranti comes. Sankranti where the sun is entering the Saturn sign. Father is taking permission of his son. Should I come? That is why we are only celebrating Makar Sankranti, not other the Sankranti. See, the people during the Makar Sankranti, they say that Tilka Abhyangasthan. Abhyangasthan means from hair to toes, nail taka pura oil lagaye. Why oil has to be kept? Because from there, sun will change its path and there will not be a sunburn. That is why they say Tilka Abhyangasthan in the Makar Sankranti. Why people eat that Til Laddu, you know? Tilka Laddu they eat. Yeah. Why? Because Til has a oil. Yeah. So they say that from inside, your body should be oily. Oil.
Well greased.
Ha, well greased. For greasing this thing. And people just see that is a festival of kite. No. Why festival of kite? Because now sun will give more energy to the earth. So that just face the sun. You will not come out and just stand. No? So they give the kite. While kite, no, your all body and that gets the heat by the sun. So all the festival has their own thing. But don't frighten. So that is a Pushya nakshatra. Pushya means to grow. It's like Guru Pushamrityo, growth of this. Then it is Anuradha. Anuradha nakshatra comes during the Jeshtha mass of the Hindu. So that time also the all elder person can't marry. Elder person can't take their own things. Why? Because Sunny was an elder son. Or Saturn, so he is restricted. And during the last nakshatra, Uttar Bhadrapad, it falls during the time of the Bhadrapad mass, where the Pitrupaks comes.
Pitrupaks.
So that time also, we say that just pay your
debts to the
Pitrus. Don't do your own deeds. So they divert your deeds toward the materialistic to the spiritualist. So that was the three stars, nakshatra of the Saturn. See, I need to say here that please don't threaten with the Saturn. People have a misconception of Saturn. Saturn doesn't give. No, it gives. But it takes something first. Something you perform, then only it will give you. Otherwise, Saturn will never give you. So, for Saturn, my dear friends, remedy for Saturn, I only advise that give something to your servant, to needy people, to ant, to elephant, to crow, because all these, then tortoise, these all are breeds of the Saturn, because they live long, they have accumulation. See, that black ant, you know the black ant, he has a tendency to accumulate everything. He is every day busy, his life is only 1.5 days, but he is totally busy for 1.5 days. Why? Because his work is to accumulate, everything he gathers, that's the things of Saturn. The crow always remind you something. Your work is pending, do that. whenever cross barking, you know, people, many females say that whenever they are cooking something, the crow will come and get ka-ka. He reminds you, have you fed someone? Otherwise, feed me. So, Satan always reminds you, do your deeds. So, don't be threatened with this.
Thank you so much, Dharmesh bhai, what you just said about crow.
Yeah.
You know, taking more time with the viewers. I hate gossip, but I also indulge in gossip. And sometimes I overindulge in gossip. And I have to do that to protect the business, you know, to find out who are the people backstabbing, etc. and all that. But there's something I've realized in that other office of mine. That's on the third floor.
Yeah.
And whenever I'm going beyond protection of business to actual gossiping, or bitching about people, which I do, and I don't mind admitting it. Behind me, a crow comes and starts.
He'll remind you that you are going against your deeds.
Yeah. Because Saturn is somehow connected with my speech and third house of communication. Yeah. It is connected. Yeah. So I'm doing something wrong, it's reminded.
Right.
In the Mumbai club, years back we used to have the Mumbai club at Khat.
Yeah.
This Raj used to say, or Amit Bhai used to say, that whenever, we used to have it on a Sunday.
Right.
All my speakers will say, Rahu Kal starting 4:30, I don't want to speak. I will say, I will give the lecture during Rahu Kal. So I will go during Rahu Kal and deliver the best lecture. I'll say, see, you know.
Yes.
But at that time, what Amit Bhai and Raj used to say, always behind me, as soon as I start lecturing, a crow will come and sit in the behind window. But another good remedy which I've seen working last year, this last few months I don't get that opportunity because I don't have a pond here. In that other office, what I used to do, every day I used to, I have outside, just outside the office in the veranda, I have a huge bowl of bucket. And I pour fresh water every day. Nice. So all crows, they come and they drink the water from it. That is one. And I used to, another remedy which was told to me was, see, these Gujaratis eat a food called ghatia.
Ghatia.
It is made of yellow colored chana.
Chana dal satin.
Chana dal.
The oily, that says satin.
Yeah. It's gram, I think so it is called. Yeah. Any of you Indians who know ghatia, how to describe it, write it in the YouTube comment so that Westerners can also do it. It is available in fried form.
Yeah, fried form.
So, and you have special ghatia for crows. Special
like
ghatia.
Crispy.
Correct.
Right.
Crispy it is. So, I used to feed them every day. Every day I used to feed them one full thali.
Right.
And that I noticed after few months, I should just do it. Now I'm telling, I don't do a remedy for the sake of remedy.
Yeah.
You know, chalo de do, you know.
Right.
So, every day I used to feed pigeons this and ants. These three every day I used to do. So, I realized after a few months that a lot of change happened in me, in my life, my fortune, etc. Try it if it works for you.
Yeah.
Another remedy, finally, I'll just take one more minute. Saturn and Rahu are two difficult planets. Most of us have these two planets very badly spoiled in our horoscope. We all want the good points about Venus. So this Anita ji had told me the remedy. It used to work earlier. These days I think my karma is so bad that remedy is not working.
Okay.
Take black til, black sesame seeds.
Yeah.
100 grams. Take white sesame seeds.
Okay.
100 grams.
Okay.
And take sugar. 100 grams. Mix it. Where you find ants, you give it to them. So, near my office, you find black ants, red ants, you get. So, the black til is for Saturn.
Saturn, right.
White til is for Rahu.
Rahu.
And that sugar is for Shukra.
Venus.
Yes. This is what I remember, I can be wrong. But, what are we doing is, you are giving somebody food that he can store for months.
Yes, yes, sir.
Even if it is not a remedy, I am saying what is the harm in doing it?
Oh, right. See, all this remedy doesn't harm you.
Yeah, I mean, in the sense, it is good for someone.
It's not pay such a high.
It's not, yeah, I mean, 30, yeah, this is 45 rupees. Yeah. You know, yes. 45 rupees, 100 grams.
Yeah.
Okay, in Gao, it might be cheaper.
Yeah.
You know, but do this, especially on a Saturday.
Yeah.
Especially on a Saturday.
Yeah, if a person have a fear, no, it is better to have something.
Yeah.
So it has satisfied that he has done something.
Mental something.
But
my only thing is, please don't follow what 99.9999% of Indians do. They do remedy in the morning, every morning. They'll feed cow, crow, this, that. Throughout the day, commit 100 sins, especially in their business. Okay? And then in the night time, there are more sins.
Yeah.
A remedy has to change you as a person. If it does not change your mind, if you are still a miser, if you are still a kamina, okay, that remedy is useless. It is only temporary. It is only giving you temporary relief, like so many remedies, Indian remedies, Lal Kitab remedies and all that. It has to change you from here.
Right.
If it doesn't change you from here, it's gone. Thank you so much, Dharmesh Bhai.
Thank you very
much. It's a pleasure having you.
Being is the Saturn, it is too much long session.
Too much long session. That's good. Thank you.
Thank you.